أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. سيد المرسلين وخاتم النبيين ورحمة للعالمين، وصلى الله على آله الطاهرين الذين أذهب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا. أوصيكم عباد الله بتقوى الله. Today is the 28th of Safar, which is the anniversary of the wafat of the greatest prophet and the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Hazrat Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And I would like to take this opportunity to talk about a story from his life. During the early days in Mecca, the early stages of Nubuwwat and the Risalat, and this is in the words of Amir al-Mu'minin Ali, where in Khutbah 192 of the Quran, which is a very famous khutbah, and it's a very long khutbah, towards the end, Amir al-Mu'mineen talks about Rasulullah, and he talks about the day when the revelation started in the cave of Hira, where he says, I was the witness there. The only witness to the coming down of the wahi the first time in form of the ayat of Quran was none other than Ali. And he talks about it, and he says, at that time I heard a cry, you know, somebody was crying. And I asked Rasulullah, who is this? And Rasulullah said, this is the cry of the shaitan. Because now he realizes that, you know, the risalat has started, the last wahi has started, and he will not be successful. After that, Amir al-Mu'mineen talks about an incident where he says, and this is what I would like to, you know, present to you. He says, I was there with him when a group of Quraysh came to him. And remember, they have been refusing to believe in him. This is the early days. And they used different labels against him. First, they just said he was a Majnoon. When that didn't work, they said he is Sha'ir, a poet. When that, you know, label didn't stick, they said he's a sorcerer. And so this is in that background that we see that a group of Quraysh came to him and they said, O Muhammad, you have made a big claim which none of your forefathers or those of your family have made. We ask you one thing. If you give us an answer to it and show it to us, then we will believe that you are a prophet and messenger. But if you cannot do it, then we will know that you are a sorcerer and a liar. And so the Prophet says, what do you ask for? What do you want? And they said, you know, they pointed towards a tree which was there. And this is the narrator is Ali, remember. Ask this tree to move for us, even with its roots, and stop before you. Ask the tree to move with its root to come towards you and stop in front of you. And the Prophet says, verily, Allah has power over everything. And if Allah does it for you, will you then believe and stand witness to the truth? They said, yes. If you show this to us, we will believe. But then this is where Rasulullah says, I shall show you what you want. But I know you wouldn't bend towards virtue, and they are among you those who will be thrown in the pit, in the fire of Jahannam. and among you are those who will form parties against me. So he's saying, okay, you ask for something, I'll do it for you. Although you have promised that you will believe in me once I've shown it to you, but I know you are not going to accept. And this is where now Rasulullah turns to the tree. Ya ayyuha tushajara, in kunti tu'minina billahi wal yawmil akhir. That, O the tree, if you believe in Allah and the Day of Judgment, وَتَعْلَمِينِ إِنْ أَنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ, and you know that I am the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then come up with your roots, come and stand before me بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ, with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so this is where we see that, you know, he asked the tree to move. But he adds this, you know, statement at the end, بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ, so people do not be confused that this is not the independent power of Rasulullah. This is a gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given to his special, you know, chosen ones. And this is where Ali now is a witness there. He says, فَوَلَّذِي بَعَثَهُ بِالْحَقِّ نَبِيًّا, that by the one who sent the Prophet with the truth, the tree removed itself, بأروقها, with its roots. وجاءت ولها دبي شديد وقصف قصف أجنحة الطير. And it came, it started moving with a great humming sound, and the branches, you know, flapping like the flapping of the wings of birds, until it stopped before Rasulullah, with some of its twigs came down, you know, on Rasul, and some of them came on my shoulder because I was standing right by the right side of Rasulullah. Now, the Quraysh asked for something. Rasulullah showed the power that he has from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The response should have been, Amanna, that we believe. But no. Now they say, well, out of arrogance, they're saying, now you order half of the tree to come further towards you and other half to stay where it is. And Rasulullah said, okay, he ordered the tree, you know, to be, yeah, that become half and half, half move forward and half stay where it is. Even then, at least now they should say, Amanna. No. They said, now ask this part which is in the front to go back and join. And Rasulullah again says, orders the other half of the tree to go back and become one. And that is where Amir al-Mu'minin could not take it anymore. So he says, he now addresses Rasul. He says, O Prophet, I am the one to believe in you and to acknowledge that the tree did what it did just now with the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a testimony to your nubuwwat and to elevate your status. And this is where you see that the reaction of the people of the Quraysh, all of them, you know, shouted in a loud voice, no, you are a sorcerer, you are a liar, and you are very expert in your sorcery, and only a person like him, pointing towards Ali, you will stand, you know, as a witness to your game. And this is where we see that when it comes to the status of Rasulullah, he was not only a good person, a person who brought the Quran, and that's the end of the story. No, he was Sayyid al-Anbiya wal-Mursaleen. He was gifted with special knowledge. He was gifted with infallibility. He was gifted with what we call wilayat taqwini, you know, authority over the universe. Of course, this is a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are not independent of Allah's will, but this is Allah's will. He gives it to whomever He wants. Salawat wa ta'ala. إن أحسن الحديث كتاب الله العزيز بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله الذي لا إله إلا هو الحليم الكريم غافر الذنب وقابل التوب وهو الغفور الرحيم. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا هو العطوف للعباد بجوده والعواد على المذنبين بحلمه. ونشهد أن محمدا نبيه وحبيبه. اللهم صل على محمد. سيد المرسلين وشفيع المذنبين ورحمة للعالمين، صلى الله عليه وآله الداعين إلى سبيل الله بالحكمة والموعظة الحسنة، قادة الأمم وولياء النعمة ومعدن الرحمة. أوصيكم عباد الله بالتوبة ما سلف من ذنوبكم. The narration that I presented to you from this khutbah from Nahjul Balagha is in a way continuation of what I mentioned last night. That for us, you know, when we look at Rasulullah, you know, even his words are wahi, according to the earlier ayat of Surah An-Najm. It is not only the Quran which is wahi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even whatever he says is based on the inspiration that Allah has given to him. And so we do not, you know, separate the life of the Prophet into official capacity and private capacity and only take one half of what he says and leave the other half. Because in order to do that, you need to be a prophet yourself to be able to distinguish, you know, when is he talking as a prophet and when he is talking as Muhammad bin Abdullah only. You know, we look at the ayat of Quran, the ita'at and obedience that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the prophet. You know, we have to obey him in an absolute sense. And that will only be possible if we take everything that he has to say on the official capacity. Many times we, you know, see this difference among the Muslims about the status of the Prophet. And we are told, well, he was a Bashar. You know, one statement I quoted last night from some of the people of the Quraysh, who asked Abdullah bin Amr ibn As not to write down whatever he hears from the words of Rasulullah. Because they told him, you know, Rasulullah basharun yatakallamu fil ghadabi wal ridha. Rasulullah is a human being like us. You know, sometimes he speaks when he's angry. Sometimes he's overjoyed about something and he might say things. Don't take things, everything seriously. And this is where we had to realize that no. And the response of Rasul was that whatever I say, whether I say it when I'm angry or I say it when I'm happy, everything is based on haqq. You will have to accept everything. And this term is used many times by many people even now. They say, you know, he was a Bashar. He came and went, Khuda Hafiz. You know, you have the Quran, that's it. You don't need him, he was just like us. Yes, he was like us, but there is something additional to it. There are many ayat of Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala quotes the words of the prophets. And for example, in Surah Kahf, ayat number 110, it says, Qul, and this is probably addressed to our own prophet, say to them, Innama ana basharun mithlukum, that verily I'm a human being like you. I'm not an angel. You know, physically, I am just like you. But immediately after that, you will see he says, and there is not even a wa there. إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشْرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ يُوحَى إِلَيَّ. I am a human being like you. As physical, you know, dimension is concerned, I am like you. I am not, you know, an angel or from other entity. But there is a difference. يُوحَى إِلَيَّ. I get a wahi and revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't get it. So yes, he is Bashar like us, but we are not Nabi like him. This is the second part with that we miss out there. He is a Bashar like us, but we are not a Nabi like him. He has that access to wahi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that knowledge that Allah gives to a, you know, a prophet like our prophet, that is the basis of everything. Ilm al-Ghaib, in the story that you saw that the prophet told Quraysh even before he did the demand that they had, that I know you will not believe. And actually it happened the way he said it. You know, and so the Ilm al-Ghaib is there in that story. Wilayat al-Takwini is there where he has the power over an item like tree, asking it to move forward with its root. And so this authority over the universe is there. Of course, all of this depends on Idhnullah. You know, and so when we look at this issue, we do realize that yes, he is Basharun Mithlukum Yuha ilayya, but he has something which we don't have. You know, the way one of these scholars, may Allah, you know, elevate his status in Jannah, explained it once where he says, you know, you look at the automobile industry. There are some companies which produces many, many brands of cars. But there are many, you know, models which are produced in thousands and thousands. But there are some brands which are only, you know, selected, you know, numbers of that. The price are different. All models come from the same company. Many, many components of both models would be same, but there is something in that few select models which are not in the common ones. So yes, Anbiya and Mursaleen are Bashar like us, but they have something which we don't have it. Manufacturer is one. Allah is Khaliq of all of us, including Anbiya and Mursaleen. He sent us as Bashar. Anbiya and Mursaleen also are Bashar, but they have something that we don't have it. And that is the difference that we have to keep in mind when we talk about the status of Anbiya and Mursaleen. Salawat on Iqbal. At the end of that khutbah, Amir al-Mu'mineen, when he describes the story, then he says, then he talks about himself and the Prophet and the family. He says, "Inni la min qawm la ta'khuduhum fi Allahi lawmatu la'im." He says, I belong to a group of people, me and my family, that we don't really take it, you know, harsh when people say things to us for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We will accept it, but we will not change our perspective and views. Simahum simas siddiqeen. You know, if you look at their image is that of siddiqeen, the most truthful of the people in their speech and their character and their belief. Kalamuhum kalamul abrar. Their speech is the speech of the righteous people. Ummarul layl wa manarul nahar. The night time they spend awake in worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but during the daytime they are the manar, they are the minaret of guidance for people. Mutamassikuna bihablil Qur'an, they are those who hold on to the rope of the Qur'an. Wa yuhyuna sunan Allah wa sunan rasulihi, and they are the one who actually maintain and keep alive the sunnah of Allah and the sunnah of the Rasul. لا يستكبرون ولا يعلون ولا يغلون ولا يفسدون. They do not behave arrogantly. They do not boast about themselves. You know, they do not do chaos and facade in this dunya. قلوبهم في الجنان وأجسادهم في العمل. Their hearts are attached to the paradise, but their action is there in this dunya. And that is Ali and Ali Ali. And unfortunately, they are, you know, a segment in the Muslim world at the moment who don't like our perspective about the Prophet and the Ahlul Bayt. And now they have moved the, you know, issue to the escalation to the level of violence. You know, again, it is really sad that things are becoming worse and worse as far as Pakistan is concerned. We just got the news yesterday that there were multiple blasts in a Shia neighborhood in Kuwait, Quetta, where you know, 100 people were killed and more than that were injured. You know, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevate the status of those who were killed because they believe in this path of Ali and include them among the shuhada and give recovery to those who have been injured and give sabr jameel to their families. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, protect all the mu'mineen all over the world and hasten the appearance of the Imam with whom will come global peace, inshallah. اللهم صل على سيد المرسلين وشفيع المذنبين نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وعلى إمام المتقين وعمير المؤمنين علي بن أبي طالب صلوات الله عليه وعلى سيدة النساء العالمين سيدتنا فاطمة بنت رسول الله صلوات الله عليها وعلى سيد الشباب أهل الجنة الحسن المجتبى والحسين الشهيد بكربلاء عليهم الصلاة والسلام اللهم صل على أئمة المسلمين علي بن الحسين ومحمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر وعلي بن موسى ومحمد بن علي وعلي بن محمد والحسن بن علي عليهم الصلاة والسلام اللهم صل على مولانا الحجة بن الحسن صاحب العصر والزمان ما أحيا صار البدء والطغيان هادم يمنة الشرك والنفاق حاسد فلو البغي والشقاق صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آبائه الكرام ما اتصلت الليالي والأيام اللهم عجل فرج وصح المخرج واكحل ناظرنا بنظرة منا إليه واجعلنا من المستشهدين بين يديه اللهم اجعلنا ممن يذكر فتنفعه الذكرى إن الله يعمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون الله.